subscribe to Go Doctor Who. And if you don't, then you can go.
Hi guys, Rush and Go Doctor here. Today we're going to do five things that made the third Doctor great. We did five things that made the first Doctor great. We did five things that made the second Doctor great. And I just released yesterday how I would run the show if I was showrunner. And it's actually a really good one and I really enjoyed doing it, so you should check it out. Anyway, yeah, this is five things that made the third Doctor great. So number one, we've got, obviously, the show first time going into colour, which is amazing. And we get to see, I suppose for the audience in that time, it was amazing to actually see TV in colour properly and the Doctor Who universe suddenly coming brighter than ever. And it's, yeah, it's got to be something that makes the show great, and it's got to be something that makes the third Doctor great. We get to see him in all his glory, none of that black and whiteness, which definitely I find hard as a viewer from the modern era to try and watch classic and see the black and white. I struggle to get into them. It kind of puts me off a bit, whereas the colour I'm totally fine with, and I can deal with the dodgy shot sets and stuff like that. And I'm just going to mention the third Doctor is my favourite classic Doctor. I love him so much, and yeah, I even love him more than Tom Baker. I'm sorry. Yeah, he's my Doctor. He's my classic Doctor. I really love him. So yeah, John Pertwee, the best Doctor in my opinion for classic Who. And he has, next up we have John Pertwee himself, the third Doctor. He's definitely more sci-fi and being able to fix things, and I think he can do, he's very scientific, he's a scientific advisor for UNIT, I mean, so why wouldn't he be? He's very much like tweaking stuff and trying to escape in his TARDIS, and yeah, I definitely think that's a highlight as well. And number three is definitely him being stuck on Earth. It's a different dynamic. The Doctor's used to travelling after adventures. He's stuck in UNIT, well, he works for UNIT now, and he's working for the Brigadier, and that is just brilliant. And him working in UNIT and being stuck in one unit is definitely something we've never really seen with the Doctor, and it's finally happened in a way. And then he goes off back to his travels after this incarnation is done with. Well, near enough to the end of this incarnation, he does get to go off, thanks to the three Doctors. So yeah, That's something different, that's something new that brings to the table, and it definitely is a highlight to the third Doctor era, the one that stayed on Earth. Next up we have the Brigadier and the third Doctor. Oh my god, this is definitely something, that dynamic of, you dare disobey me, Doctor, I am your advisor. And then the 13th Doctor just doesn't care, he just doesn't, and it's just lovely, and I love that dynamic of Brigadier trying to be one up on him, but he can never. And they're just a friendly dynamic, and it's just lovely. And every time you see them together on screen, you're just like, oh, what's gonna happen? I really enjoy this. And yeah, I just love that dynamic. I think it's really, yeah, it's ace. Also, finally on the list, the companions. The third Doctor, in my opinion, had the best classic companions in his run, literally. They are definitely what made the third Doctor great in his era, because basically we had Jo Grant as the Doctor in JoJo, I think she is now, but yeah, it's incredible, she's amazing, she's lovely, she's sweet, she's kind, and yes, she was the typical Who girl in a way, going, ah, help me Doctor, but she was still amazing. And then, yeah, we got Sarah Jane Smith, and oh, you know how much I love Sarah Jane Smith if you're a regular on this channel. And I did three videos on her 2 weeks ago, actually. Talking about Sarah Jane Smith, the Unmade Sarah Jane Adventures. I just did a video on that, and that's quite popular on the channel. And I did Farewell Sarah Jane. So yeah, I did them videos just recently, so check them out. But yeah, Sarah Jane, oh, I absolutely love her, and she's a badass. And there's not much more to say than what I said in them videos, so you should check them out to find out what I think about Sarah Jane. But she definitely made that dynamic with the third Doctor and Sarah Jane brilliantly well. So yes, there's definitely five things that made the third Doctor great, and this is my favourite era of classic Who so far. I've got a lot more to watch of classic Who, but I've loved this one the most. I've jumped into each Doctor's, but this one is the one that I fully attach to the most. So yes, there's five things, guys, that made the third Doctor great. And I will see you guys tomorrow for another daily video.